Hello everyone. In this session, I am going to explain about correction factor for multipass and cross flow heat exchanger. Now coming to overview of this session, first I will explain correction factor. Then we will solve two problems on correction factor. Now coming to correction factor, at what situation we have to use this correction factor? LMTD relations derived is only applicable for parallel flow and counter flow heat exchangers only. Other than parallel flow and counter flow heat exchangers, LMTD temperature cannot be considered as mean temperature difference. In such cases, the appropriate mean temperature difference can be obtained by introducing a correction factor F to the log mean temperature difference for counterflow arrangement with the same hot and cold fluid temperatures. That is, delta TLM is the mean temperature difference, is calculated with the help of multiplying LMTD into this correction factor. For the heat transfer analysis of cross flow and shell and tube heat exchanger, this correction factor is required. In order to find out mean temperature difference for cross flow and shell and tube heat exchangers, first we have to find out LMTD considering counter flow heat exchanger. Then we have to multiply correction factor F to the LMTD temperature what we have calculated. Then we will get final mean temperature difference delta TLM. Now we will see the different cases of this correction factor. First case is one shell pass and two tube pass or multiple of two tube pass. This condition will be mentioned in the problem. So correction factor F can be calculated with the help of P and R value. X axis is P, Y axis is R, Y axis F. Here R is mentioned here. R is mentioned here, x axis is P, y axis is F, and R values are mentioned here. Now we will see the second graph, that is for two shell passes and 4, 8, 12, that is any multiple of 4 tube passes. Correction factor F can be found out with the help of P value and R value. One more thing we have to remember here, capital T and small t values. Capital T value refers to shell side temperature, small t refers to tube side temperature. Okay. Now we will see the third type, that is the cross flow, both fluid unmixed. Cross flow means two fluids will flow perpendicular to each other. Correction factor F can be calculated with the help of R and P value. X axis P value, Y axis is correction factor F value, and these curves are R values. Based on R and P value, you can find out this correction factor. And in fourth diagram, fourth graph, it is refers to single pass cross flow heat exchanger, one fluid mixed and other fluid unmixed. It is a cross flow type heat exchanger, in that one fluid is mixed, other fluid is unmixed. So by referring P and R value, you can find out F value, correction factor. Please remember this, temperature capital T refers to shell side temperature and small t refers to tube side temperature value. Because these two temperatures are required to find out P and R value. Based on P and R value, you will get correction factor F. Now we will see first problem. A two shell pass and four tube passes heat exchanger is used to heat glycerin from 20 degree Celsius to 50 degree Celsius by hot water, which enters thin walled 20 mm diameter tube at 80 degree Celsius and leaves at 40 degree Celsius. The total length of the tube In the heat exchanger is 60 meter. The convection coefficient on shell side is 25 watt per meter square Kelvin, and that on water side is 160 watt per meter square Kelvin. Calculate rate of heat transfer in the heat exchanger. There are two cases they have mentioned. You have to find out, calculate rate of heat transfer considering fouling factor and without considering fouling factor. First, you have to consider the clean surface, that means no need to consider fouling factor. And second case, fouling factor value is mentioned. So in this case, you have to consider fouling factor and find out heat transfer rate Q value. First, you see the schematic diagram of the problem. The water is entering into the tube at 80 degrees Celsius and leaves at 40 degrees Celsius. Glycerin enters at 20 degrees Celsius and leaves at 50 degrees Celsius. You have to consider counter flow heat exchanger for finding LMTD. Remember that. So whatever the given data, shell side and tube side mentioned here, TCI, TC naught, H naught and RF naught values. Similarly for tube side, diameter is 20 mm, L 60 meter, THI 80 degrees Celsius, TH naught 40 degrees Celsius, HI value 160 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now we have to find out rate of heat transfer without considering fouling. Formula becomes Q is equal to U into area into delta T LM, mean temperature difference. So area is required in order to find out Q value. So first find area. Area is pi dl, pi into 0.02 into 60, you will get 3.77 meter square. Then we have to find out LMTD, LMTD temperature for counter flow. Delta T1 and delta T2 values 30 and 20 degrees Celsius. And finally, you will get LMTD as 24.66 degrees Celsius. Now we will find out mean temperature difference by introducing this correction factor F. For the correction factor, first we have to find out P and R value. P and R value. P value is equal to 0.67, R value is equal to 0.75. Capital T refers to shell side, small t refers to tube side. Now you go to the graph B. If you go to the graph B, you will get the correction factor for the value of 0.67 as P and 0.75 for R, you will get F value as 0.88. Go to x-axis P value, x-axis P value, that is 0.67. If you consider somewhere here, it will come 0.67, and R value is 0.75, 0.7 somewhere in between these two, 0.6 and 0.8 is lying in between, you will get 0.75. Okay, so you will get 0.67 for P value somewhere here, and you will get 0.88 as F value, 0.88 value, 0.88 as F value. Now coming to the problem, correction factor F, 0.88 you got, that you multiply with the LMTD temperature, finally you will get mean temperature difference as 0.88 into 24.66 as 21.7 degree Celsius. This value 0.88 or 0.9 will be the approximated value. Okay, from the graph, whatever value we got is approximated value. No need to worry about the 0.88 or 0.9, 0.91. Okay, appropriate value by referring P value and R value you will get. Now we will find out overall heat transfer coefficient for clean surface without considering fouling factor. And one more thing, wall resistance is neglected here because it is nowhere mentioned. That is why the wall resistance is neglected. And find out U value, 1 by 1 by HI plus 1 by H naught as 21.62 watt per meter square Kelvin. Finally, heat transfer rate is equal to 1768.7 watt. Q is equal to U A delta T L M. All values we have now, just substitution. Now we will consider with the fouling factor, find out U value, then Q value. Fouling factor they have mentioned, RF value. Just consider that 0.666, 0006, and find out 21.634 is the value of U, then find out Q value. All values we have just substitution, 1746.2 meter square. Now coming to next problem, an automobile radiator has 40 tubes of inner diameter of 0.5 centimeter and 60 centimeter long in a closely spaced plate finned matrix. So both fluid unmixed, please underline this. So both fluid unmixed, the one condition, hot water enters the tube at 90 degrees Celsius at a rate of 0.6 kg per second and leaves at 65 degrees Celsius. Air flows across the radiator through the inner fin or inter fin spaces and is heated from 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. Calculate overall heat transfer coefficient based on inner surface area of the radiator. This also you have to mention, because overall heat transfer coefficient, there are two cases are there, based on inner and outer. Here it is mentioned inner surface area, UI you have to find out. So it is not a parallel flow or not a counter flow. It is a type of automotive radiator. It is an example for crossed flow heat exchanger, crossed flow heat exchanger, and both fluid unmixed. This is the condition we have to refer for correction factor F. Graph C refers to crossed flow, both fluid unmixed. Okay, the schematic representation of the problem is here, automotive radiator. In that you can observe the air is flowing in this direction, water is flowing in this direction. So perpendicular to each other, two fluids will flow perpendicular to each other. It refers to cross flow heat exchanger. Now this is the number of tubes are arranged. Total number of tubes is 40, length is 60 centimeter, all temperatures are mentioned. So given data refers to automotive radiator. N is 40, DI is 0.5 centimeter converted into meter, L 60 centimeter converted into meter 0.6 meter, THI 90 degrees Celsius, TH0 65 degrees Celsius, mass flow rate of hot fluid 0.6 kg per second, TCI 20 degrees Celsius, TC0 40 degrees Celsius. To find out overall heat transfer coefficient based on inner surface area, the following assumptions are made first. Because specific heat of water is nowhere mentioned in the problem, but it is required to find out Q value for energy balance equation. So you have to assume specific heat of water as 4.18 kJ per kg Kelvin. You should know this value because it is a standard value under atmospheric condition, 4.18 kJ per kg Kelvin. And fouling factor is not mentioned, so we are assuming that it is a clean tube surface without any fouling. So from the energy balance equation for the radiator, for the hot fluid side, Q is equal to m dot h cph thi minus th naught, you will get Q as 62.7 kilowatt. Now total heat transfer area based on inner surface area you have to consider, because overall heat transfer coefficient they have asked based on inner surface area. So AI is equal to pi DI L into N, you will get 0.377 meter square. Here you have to consider not only pi DL, number of tubes they have mentioned. If number of tubes not mentioned, no need to worry about this number of tubes N, just to find out pi DL. But in this problem they have mentioned number of tubes, that is 40, just to multiply, because for overall heat transfer coefficient you need total area, not individual tube area. That is why 40 you have to multiply here. So area of inlet 0.377 meter square. Here delta T1, delta T2 to find out the counter flow. All temperatures we know, just find out, just substitution, and finally you will get 47.45 degrees Celsius. Now we have to find out mean temperature difference by introducing correction factor F. We have to find out log mean temperature difference for cross flow heat exchanger by introducing F, that is correction factor. For that we need P and R value. Capital T refers to shell side, small t refers to tube side, please remember that. So by referring graph C, if you go to graph C, here it is mentioned, you see cross flow and both fluid unmixed. This is the condition they have mentioned. This condition is directly mentioned, but cross flow you should know, because radiator they have mentioned, radiator is a crossed flow heat exchanger. For that, p value 0.357 and r value 0.8, p value 0.35 somewhere here, 0.357, and r value is 0.8, r value 0.8 here, r value come here, and 0.357 and r value 0.8 somewhere intersect here. So you will get f value as 0.98, f value as 0.98 or 0.97. The log mean temperature difference for cross flow heat exchanger is given by this correction factor is multiplied with the LMTD temperature. So the final log mean temperature difference for cross flow heat exchanger is 46 degrees Celsius. The overall temperature coefficient, overall heat transfer coefficient Ui is equal to Q divided by Ai into delta T Lm. Just substitution, all values we have now, 3615.5 watt per meter square Kelvin. So correction factor is required in other than parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger. So log mean temperature difference for cross flow and counter flow, cross flow and shell and tube heat exchanger, this correction factor is required. So with this I will conclude this session. The following references are used for the preparation of these slides. Thank you.